Quadratic Equations, Level 2. Alright, in this video, we will start solving quadratic monomials of the form ax squared equals 0, and quadratic binomials of the form ax squared plus c equals 0. Let's first learn how to solve quadratic monomials. The general procedure in solving quadratic monomials is to solve for x by getting rid of the coefficient a and then taking the square root of both sides of the equation. Let's show how this is done. Solve the equation 3x squared equals 0. Alright, anytime we are trying to solve for an equation, we need to follow a logical sequence of steps that would help us isolate the variable. In this case, we are solving for x. So we first need to get rid of 3. So we divide by 3 on both sides of the equation. 3 over 3 reduces to 1. And 0 divided by 3 reduces to 0. Next step is to get rid of the power. So we take the square root of both sides. The square root of x squared is equal to the absolute value of x, and the square root of 0 is equal to 0. So now we ask ourselves, when does the absolute value of x equal 0? Well, this occurs when x equals 0. And this is our final answer. If we were to graph the left-hand side of the equation, we would obtain the following graph. Notice that the parabola touches the x-axis once. This means that we are dealing with a repeated root, also known as a double or multiple root. Remember, quadratic equations always generate two solutions. In this case, we have a repeated root at x equals 0. This is why the graph touches the x-axis only once. This is probably the easiest type of quadratic equation you will ever get, because every single quadratic equation of this form has 0 as its solution. So we are technically done with these types of quadratic equations. The key thing I want you to take away from this problem is the fact that whenever you take the square root of a variable squared, you end up with the absolute value of that variable. This idea is going to be important when we start talking about quadratic binomials. Recall that this is the definition of the absolute value. Specifically, that the square root of x squared is equal to the absolute value. You will be amazed how many students who start their first course in calculus forget or never even heard of such definition. So with that said, let's move along and solve quadratic binomials of the form ax squared plus c equals 0. The general steps in solving these types of quadratic equations is once again to solve for the unknown variable. We typically want to get rid of the constant c, then get rid of the coefficient a, and finally take the square root of both sides of the equation. Let's try the following example. Solve the equation x squared minus 4 equals 0. We first need to get rid of the 4, so we add 4 to both sides of the equation. The left-hand side of the equation signifies to x squared, and the right side signifies to 4. Now, since the coefficient on x squared is equal to 1, we go ahead and take the square root of both sides. Doing that, we obtain the following. The square root of x squared reduces to the absolute value of x, and the right side of the equation reduces to 2. So now we have the equation, the absolute value of x equals 2. So now we ask ourselves, when does the absolute value of x equal 2? Recall that there are two solutions for these types of equations. The first is when x equals 2, and the second is when x equals negative 2. It's always a good idea to check your answer, so doing that we see that 2 squared minus 4 reduces to 0, so that checks out. And negative 2 squared minus 4 also reduces to 0. Both solutions work. If we were to graph this equation, we would obtain the following graph. Notice that this parabola crosses the x-axis twice, once at negative 2, 0, and once at 2, 0. Hence, the quadratic equation has two solutions. Another thing I want you to notice is that once again, whenever we take the square root of a variable squared, we obtain the absolute value of that variable, yielding two solutions. As a result, from this point on, I'm going to skip this step and use the following symbol, immediately after taking the square root of a variable squared. This symbol is read positive negative. This is a shorthand way of representing the positive and negative value of a number. So instead of writing x equals 2 and x equals negative 2, we write it in one line as x equals positive negative 2. Keep this in mind when dealing with this symbol. We actually have two solutions, the positive and negative of the number. Alright, let's move along and try the following problem. Solve the equation negative 3x squared plus 15 equals 0. We first need to isolate x by itself. So we subtract 15 from both sides of the equation, as follows, and obtain negative 3x squared equals negative 15. Next, we get rid of negative 3 by dividing both sides by negative 3. Doing that, we obtain x squared is equal to negative 15 over negative 3, which reduces to positive 5. And lastly, we take the square root of both sides and obtain the following. X is equal to positive negative the square root of 5. And this is our final answer. Remember, we always have two answers, and we use this symbol to represent the positive and negative square root of 5. This is very important. Many students forget to include the positive-negative symbol and only get half the credit on their quizzes and tests, because technically, they only wrote one answer. So keep this in mind, and make sure you include the positive and negative symbol. Alright, let's try the next one. Solve the equation x squared plus 9 equals 0. Alright, we solve for x by subtracting 9 from both sides of the equation, and obtain x squared equals negative 9. Next, we take the square root of both sides and obtain x is equal to positive negative the square root of negative 9. Now, depending where you are in the curriculum, the answer is either no solution, because you were told that you can't take the square root of a negative number, or if you have covered imaginary numbers, this expression can be simplified as positive negative 3i, because the square root of negative 1 is by definition equal to I. Notice that in this problem, we ended up with imaginary numbers. So if we were to graph this equation, we would obtain the following graph. Notice that the parabola never crosses the x-axis. Hence, this equation has no real number solutions. But in theory, this equation must always have two solutions. In this case, they are imaginary, as opposed to real numbers. A quadratic can have either real or imaginary solutions, so don't freak out if you end up with imaginary numbers as your solution. It's completely normal. Alright, let's try the final example. Solve the equation 4x squared minus 9 equals 3 plus x squared. It seems that this problem looks ridiculously insane. Well, it's not that bad. All we have to do is to write it in standard form first. Then the equation can be solved similarly, like the previous examples. Let's go ahead and write this expression in standard form by collecting like terms. In other words, we get all the constants and variables in one side, and at the same time, making sure we arrange the degrees in descending order, and leaving the other side of the equation equal to 0. It really doesn't matter if 0 ends up in the left or the right side of the equation. As long as it's in standard form, everything will work out. So let's go ahead and get all the terms to the left side. So we first subtract 3 from both sides and simplify to obtain 4x squared minus 12 equals x squared. Then we subtract x squared from both sides and obtain 3x squared minus 12 equals 0. Now we have it in standard form. Next, we go ahead and start solving for x. So we add 12 to both sides and obtain 3x squared equals 12. Then we divide both sides by 3 and obtain x squared equals 12 over 3, which simplifies to 4. Finally, we take the square root of both sides and obtain the value of x, which is equal to positive negative the square root of 4, which simplifies to positive negative 2. And this is our final answer. So in this problem, our equation was not written nicely for us. We actually had to rewrite it in standard form first before we attempted to solve for x. So make sure you write it in standard form first before solving any quadratic equation. Alright, this is how you solve quadratic monomials of the form ax squared equals 0 and quadratic binomials of the form ax squared plus c equals 0. In our next video, we will learn how to solve a slightly more difficult version of quadratic binomials of the form ax squared plus c equals 0.